What is up everyone, my name is Faisal and welcome back to another episode. If you are around new here, today I'm going to talk about how we can create the overlay animation in Figma. So I'm going to show you two examples how you can create sidebar like this and pop-up like this. So let's get started. So I already created this e-commerce layout for this tutorial. So we already defined everything. The first thing is a home page and second thing are components. First is a sidebar, second is a model. So right now we're going to select the card icon and we want to create an interaction while we click on this icon. So for this we have to click on this prototype over here. So we have a two ways. Either we can click on this plus icon and we can drag and select whatever value we want after click this, or we can simply click on the plus icon. I prefer this way because it's a very easy way. So I'm gonna connect my connector with the sidebar. As you can see, it's connected, and now as you can see over here is on click. It's called event. I want to overlay the sidebar, so we are going to focus on the open overlay tutorial in this class. So just click on this, and after this you can see our components already selected. If it is not, you can just click and select. And after this, let's see the first example, it's gonna work or not. So simply you can click and you can click on a play button over here. Now let's click. Now you can see it's working. Very good. Now let's talk about the more advanced thing. So the first pro tip over here, if you want to select this property type property, you can simply select this connector and you will see the whole property is coming. So let's talk about a little bit overlay over here, from where you want this property, from the left, from the right. So simply let's take an example. You can see it's coming from the right, left. So what we want from the right, and you can change all property over here. Now I want to focus on a little bit about the background overlay. So this is a beautiful feature in Figma, so you don't need to create additional background overlay for the prototype animation. So what you can do, you can simply click on this background behind overlay. We can call it backdrop also. As you can see, we can choose a color and we can select the opacity. So I prefer 40-35. So if I click on the card, you will see simple overlay animation is coming and it's highlighting more, having a more great user experience. So let's go back to the next thing. Let's add smooth animation. So for this I'm gonna work on the move in, and after this what direction you want. So I want from the right. So let's see. Again, you can just press R and refresh your prototype window. So just click on this. Now you see the animation is happening with the smooth transition. We can use different types of transitions over here, whatever you want, and you see the example over here. But in this video I'm gonna focus on more dynamic. So I really want to create some kind of custom animation, and for this, see, we have this graph. Right now in Figma we have a small bug. Maybe they will surely fix this bug, but we are going to use custom properties over here. So this property called cubic brazier. So if you search on a Google, you can find this cubic brazier is helping to make more smooth your transition and animation. So example, I have some of the cubic animation. As you can see over here how it's working like this. So there's lots of example. So example, I'm gonna use this one. So what I can do, what I have to do, I have to select only cubic numeric property, and I just copy this property and I go into my Figma and I just paste it over here. The graph is dramatically changed, and there's some kind of like properties, like a starting from this slow and then going fast or whatever. So let's see. I'm refreshing once again and click. You see how realistic it is. So I have another property which I copy and pasting over here. So this is kind of similar, but it has a more smooth animation. So you can see it's working pretty good. I think you understand about this. Maybe you can search out about the cubic brazier and it will helpful for you to make more beautiful smooth animation experience. So now let's talk about one more thing. So in our prototype we have a close button, but we are not using right now. So you can do two things over here. The first thing, maybe you can click on this close when I clicking outside. So simply click and then refresh. If I'm opening and clicking outside is closing, It's creating simple, smooth experience. How we can close this by clicking on the close button? This is a question. So for this, what we have to do, we have to select our close button and or you close trigger and simply drag into the home page. So now you can see it's connected with this. We want to click navigate to this, and now we are choosing move out over here, and move out is going back to the right side again. So let's see how it's working. If I click and this, you see it's working beautifully, and it's working in both way. Right now if I click outside, it's also closing. So this is how you can create simple beautiful prototype with the help of cubic brazier animation. And for overlay pop-up, we have a totally different approach, because right now, as you can see, I don't have any button or I don't have any interaction over here. So how we can achieve this pop-up animation without touching any property? So the first thing what we can do, we can simply select the home page over here, and after this we can click on this plus button, or either you can just click and select your pop-up. Again, we are going to select open overlay animation because we want overlay on this. We are going to select a different event which is called after delay. So I want after 0.8 second, I want this pop-up is appear. Let's see the example. If I go over here and if I refresh, you will see the pop-up is coming. Let's put an animation which is simple animation called move in, and what I want now from the bottom to top. So it's a pretty simple, and I have a same property, and let's see how it's working. You can change also timing, whatever timing you want, or you also can delay time. It's totally your choice. So now let's connect the close button with this also. So simply select your board, and after this select on the move out. You even select a different types of property, like a push or push property, which is going pushing from the top or left or whatever. But right now I'm gonna select on the moving out. When I close, it should be go down. And even you can click on the smart animation, which is helping to matching your layers, give a more smoother experience in your transition. So I click over here. So let's go back to this pop-up, refreshing once again, and now click. Now it's going back. Now I want to give you some tips on this, which will be very helpful while you are working on your animation. So the first thing, remember you cannot connect your prototype with the group or with the rectangle. So if you select this, if you want to connect this thing, it will not work. It will not work. It only work with the artboard. If you have an artboard, you can connect your artboard. Or if you have a symbol, you can simply connect. If I make this symbol now, you can. So this is a main point, keep in your mind while you're working on the prototype. So guys, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and you learned something about the Figma prototype animation. So if you have any question regarding this, please let me know in the comment box. And if you are new, if you want to see more videos, please hit the subscribe button. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching this video.